What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. YouTube has asked us to make a video about Article 13, also known as the Directive on Copyright in the Digital Single Market, aka the EU Copyright Directive. Let's go! Right, and before we start, I have to tell you guys, I haven't been shaving myself lately because it's Movember, and in Movember you grow your mustache.
I don't really have a mustache.
And you grow your beard for the good cause, because it's to promote prostate cancer awareness. So that's the reason why I haven't been shaving. But that will change all from December 1st. But until then, I'm going to keep everything as it is. But let's continue on the subject that matter. Now you might wonder, what's the EU Copyright Directive? I'm going to read it out loud for you just a small bit so you understand what it is. Here goes. The Directive on Copyright in the Digital Single Market, also known as the EU Copyright Directive, is a controversial proposed European Union directive intended to ensure a well-functioning marketplace for the exploitation of works and other subject matter, taking into account in particular digital and cross-border uses of protected content. It extends existing European Union copyright law and is a component of the EU's Digital Single Market project. You guys still here? Let's go. Basically, what that means is they want to protect everything that has copyright on it. So music from musicians, art from artists, and content from content creators. A lot of people are against this EU copyright directive, but I'm going to tell you guys why I think it's an amazing thing to do, because it will completely change the way YouTube is being used and other video platforms or music platforms are being used. The first reason why I think it's an amazing thing to do is because I think musicians and artists and content creators, their content needs to be protected in order for them to make sure it doesn't get pirated. And I'm not talking about the RR pirates. You see, if we would just pirate everything there is, they wouldn't be able to make a living, and they wouldn't be able to provide for themselves and take the time to provide us with content, to sit down, create content, think of songs, think of music, think of beats, think of whatever you want to think about, and then produce it, because everybody needs a stream of income in order for them to make a living, in order to do what they can do best. Another reason why I think it's an amazing thing is because there are a lot of content creators using the content of others to promote themselves and to get rich from it. For instance, you've got people that create videos, reaction videos about comedians, reaction videos about different vloggers. You've got a lot of vloggers that are using the names of Casey Neistat, Peter McKinnon, anyone you can think about in order to promote themselves. They are making a breakdown video on how they make something, how they supposedly vlog, what it does to them if Casey tells them, no, I don't have any time for you. Or when they make a video that contains a lot of B-roll and they call it the Peter-like B-roll video, look at what I did. Personally, I absolutely hate it, and the reason why is because I think you need to grow organically and from your own strength and your own uniqueness and everything that gets involved with the creative process itself. Article 13 prevents you using the content of others unless you can prove the content is yours to begin with. License and registration, please. That's amazing. So for instance, the video that I'm making right now, it's in my house, it's got me in the picture, so everything is absolutely mine. The music that will be played during this video is from Epidemic Sound. Now, that's a third reason why I think Article 13 is a great thing to use. I mean, implement.
Read the rules, people, read the rules. We don't have them for nothing.
You see, there are a lot of platforms that offer music. SoundCloud, Spotify, Deezer, YouTube itself, Artlist, Epidemic Sound, and those platforms will grow, but there's a huge but, because... By the way, if you don't agree with me, feel free to leave a comment down below why you don't agree with me. The thing is, with Artlist and Epidemic Sound, I'm going to use those two as an example because I'm using Epidemic Sound myself, is you've got a subscription, and that subscription allows you to use the music on their website in all of your videos, and it's basically license free. You're paying for the license to use that music.
But if you have the copyright of those songs, then what's the problem?
The thing is, if you use that music and you pay the license for it, everything should be fine. The only downside about this is that you need to prove you have a license, but those companies do it themselves. If I use music from Epidemic Sound in my videos, I don't get flagged for copyright because I had to link my account to the Epidemic Sound account. So in their algorithms, algorithms, they can see that, okay, that guy has paid a license, he's got a subscription with us, so it's okay for him to use that music.
You see, and this is why I don't understand why YouTube, Google, Facebook, and all those big parties are making a big deal out of this.
All those companies have to do is get a checkbox that says, okay, if I, the creator, upload this content, I hereby declare that everything is mine, including the music, and all copyright lawsuits and everything that may come forward from it is all my responsibility and not the responsibility of the platform itself.
Another thing they should do
is whitelist several companies. So for instance, let's say YouTube whitelists Epidemic Sound and Artlist, so they know if people have a subscription, they use their music, it won't be flagged for copyright. If you use an Oasis song, if you use a Coldplay song, you'll get flagged for copyright and the video will be taken down, your account will be taken down, or it's possible that it will be taken down, or you can mute the audio.
And that's how it is right now. All they gotta do is make a checkbox and make sure that the content creators stay responsible for the content they put on their platform.
Right, in short, this means no more Fortnite accounts, no more meme accounts, no more reaction accounts or videos, no more videos in which you use content of a different content creator in order for you to make a buck out of it or to become famous of it. So I'm really looking forward to see what will happen within the European Union with Article 13. The only downside I see is that musicians that make covers of popular music songs will have a problem because basically they can't make videos about that anymore because they might be flagged for copyright issues. That will make finding talent online pretty hard, but other than that, I'm very excited to see what Article 13 will bring us.
And that's it. Let me know what you think about this video about Article 13. Let me know what you think about Article 13 itself. Leave a comment down below. Let's continue the discussion over there. I would love to hear your guys' thoughts. And then I'll see you guys on Thursday again for my next tutorial.